It's Sonny and Finn's Wrestling and Video Game Podcast. This week we talk the latest gaming news, we run down the games of November, and give our thoughts on WWE Hell in a Cell.
What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 37 of the Sonny and Finn Show. I'm Sonny, and with me, as always, is Finn Steele.
Hello.
How are you?
Very good, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. I've just realised that I'm not facing you at all. I'm literally just facing the complete other way. So I'm going to sit. I'm going to move where I'm sitting.
There we go.
That's better. I can see your pretty face now.
You're welcome.
What have you been up to? Been up too much?
Lots of gaming. Lots of videos and editing and all that.
Okay.
What have I been playing? Played some Castlevania on Halloween. I'm live streaming it.
Yep, you did.
So difficult. Oh my god.
It looks so hard. I've never played it before. It just looked really difficult.
It's so difficult, dude. I don't know how kids in the 80s beat Castlevania. I was using save states and this and that. I still couldn't bloody beat it. I was like, this is it. This is the night I'll beat Castlevania. Nope, didn't happen.
Were you planning on your NES?
No, I think on the emulator.
Oh.
I do own it. I think I own it on the Wii Virtual Console. So it's legal, kind of, still, I guess. Kind of.
Technically.
Yeah, it's fine. But yeah, it's a super fun game. Super difficult. Most people say Castlevania 3 is harder, but I've beaten Castlevania 3 without save states, so...
The thing with it is, like, with games, like, in the 80s and stuff, it's, like, just looks really, like, janky, and, like, the jumping and stuff.
Yeah,
it just screws you up.
Yeah, it's so janky. But...
And those bits where you were getting hit by enemies, and they hit you so far that you just fall off the edge, and it's
exactly.
Like, oh, that sucks.
As a common Castlevania thing, yeah.
Yeah.
Bloody Medusa hits. Ugh. Hit them.
It was pretty cool, though.
Yeah, super cool.
Just like to thank everybody who came out to our Hell in a Cell prediction stream this past Sunday.
Yes.
We had a really fun time, pretty much up until the end.
Yeah,
some clown wanted to try and ruin it for us by creating 17 different YouTube accounts and proceeding to dislike our stream on all of them. So that was good, but other than that, it was a lot of fun. So thank you to our regulars and new people alike that came along to the stream. That was great.
Thank you. Yes, that was awesome.
We are now at 101 subscribers on YouTube.
Woo!
And we do now have our own YouTube URL.
Yay!
Which is www.youtube.com/SonnyFinnPlay.
Yeah.
Good times.
Good times. Great times.
I did a stream of Batman Arkham VR this morning.
Nice.
Blasted through the whole thing in 38 minutes.
Cool.
Whilst looking like an idiot trying to get some trophies as well. But we'll go back in and we'll get the trophies.
It's hard not to look like an idiot while playing VR.
This is true.
Big things strapped in your head. We're flailing around like a bad man.
But there was a part in it was a trophy I was trying to get that I was telling you about before.
Oh, yeah.
And I was literally throwing a security card at a cabinet thinking that's what I had to do.
Yeah.
One
cabinet.
Yeah, if you want to see it, just go back and like fast forward to about 25 minutes into the stream. You'll see me... looking just completely stupid. But we're getting a lot more content going on the channel.
Yeah,
it's cool. Good times. I want to do a stream of Until Dawn Rush of Blood.
That'd
be pretty cool.
Yeah,
and
cool.
I was going to suggest maybe you and I revisiting the sports bar again.
Oh yeah, that'd be
maybe,
cool.
Maybe later on this afternoon.
Yeah, sure, we can do that.
Okay.
What up, VR? Sports bar VR.
Yeah, and it was a good fun last week as well.
So much fun.
Yeah. And now I've figured out how to play pool. I'm whooping the computer.
Awesome.
Just cannot stop me.
Oh, you're going to beat me to death then. I'm terrible at it still.
Oh, yeah, I am. It seems you taught me how to use the Hulk hands thing on the...
Oh, yeah.
And I'm like the Jimmy White of VR pool.
Yes, I'm like the Finn Steele of pool. He's just terrible.
Well, the Jimmy White's a snooker player. I'm sure he can play pool. Everyone who plays snooker can play pool.
But yeah, pretty much. The same thing. Come on.
Sort of.
Yep,
so. Smaller balls.
Smaller balls.
First sneaker, not pool.
Yeah. Is it?
Sports.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Is it what sneaker?
Pool sports.
Yeah.
You used to watch sneaker?
Yeah, yeah.
That's an interesting thing.
Yeah. It's my face.
Are you into it properly or?
Not super into it, but my dad used to watch it and I was like, oh, I sat down and watched it with him.
Ah, snooker.
Yeah. I know the colours of the balls, order you have to put them in.
Go for it.
Yellow, green, brown, blue, pink, black.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm impressed.
Thank you.
I should have got you on Big Break.
Big Break, yeah. It's only a game show.
Is that what you were referencing last week when we were playing Sports Bar?
Possibly. What was I saying?
Well, it was something about funny people playing pool on that TV show.
Oh, no, I was talking about that Mitchell and Webb thing.
Oh, actually, yeah, I do remember. Yeah, you did say that.
And that's a bad mix.
See, initially, I thought you meant Big Break.
Oh. Yeah, I'll reference Big Break tonight.
You can reference Big Break later.
Yeah.
Guys, this is the Sonny and Finn Show. We are a weekly video game and wrestling podcast that posts every single Friday across podcast services everywhere. Mm-hmm. Finn, what have you been playing?
What else? Headmaster on VR.
Oh, how you find it?
By your recommendation. Awesome. So funny.
It's so funny.
And timing as well. Like, I take my headset off and it's like covered in sweat. I just get like wet wipe and wipe down.
It's crazy. It doesn't help that we have sort of like, if we had bald heads, I think we'd be okay.
Probably. It's our sweaty,
so now we're slipping off our head.
Yeah. Zip. Poof. Smash.
But yeah, it's really, really cool. It's so funny. Like, the writing is amazing.
Yeah. Highly recommend it if you have
PS4. Such a simple idea as well.
Yeah, it's simple. Just headballs come at you. Aim at targets.
Yeah.
So much fun.
How far in are you? Some of them are quite difficult, I think.
I'm trying to 3-star them as I go along. Which is annoying. That's on me. I haven't got to the first exam yet. I'm almost at the first exam.
I'm at the final exam.
Oh, nice.
And it's hard.
Is it?
It's really, really hard.
Yeah. Trophy's a hard one to get then. 3-starring all the things.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I've only aced one of the exams, and I think I did it by accident.
Nice.
But it's such an awesome game.
It's so good.
Yeah. What else?
What else have I been playing? Oh, I finished Bioshock. Platinum that. Yay. On Survivor Difficulty, no bit of chambers.
How much stress did it cause you on a scale of 1 to 10?
It gets easier as it goes along. Once you get the crossbow, you can pretty much one-shot splicers if you aim for the head. It's still very difficult. But yeah, like a 7. Like a 7 out of 10.
7 out of 10 for stress.
Yeah.
Okay. But you've got the platinum now.
So got the platinum. It's a great game. I love playing it. Yeah, it's a great story.
So are you now going to go for the platinum on Bioshock 2 and Infinite?
Probably, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, not straight away. I'm going to give it to Break and Bioshock if you want other things. Whoops, not microphone. I've also been playing World of Final Fantasy, which I streamed the first part of. Probably stream some more sometime this week. This is adorable.
I watched a lot of your stream, and it looks super fun and it's super dreadful. Cute. And I love the graphics. I think it looks really, really awesome.
Yeah, it's like a cartoony kind of art style, but the art style's really great. It works well. It's like a simplified old school version of, old school Final Fantasy combat system, with added Pokemon. So, like, you collect monsters and build teams and stuff, which is awesome and great.
Yeah, it was quite interesting actually before you started the stream and you texted me saying people in our stream, in our little community, probably won't be really that into it.
Yeah.
But obviously, like, in the comments, Griff, who was one of our regulars, he was like super into it in the comments.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
He's disappointed because he's got an Xbox One and it's a PS4 exclusive. So
yeah.
He's interested in you streaming more of it, I believe.
Yeah, I'll stream more.
But yeah, that looks super cool. I was considering getting that, but I'm going to wait for Final Fantasy 15 later on this month instead.
Good choice.
But yeah, it looks super cool.
Yep, same as well. Other than that, I think that's about it, honestly. How about what you've been playing?
I've been playing Titanfall 2.
Oh, nice.
And I love it.
Cool.
I've played a little bit in the single player, which is cool so far.
Yeah, very good things.
Very standard single player campaign FPS sort of stuff, but it's cool.
Excellent.
I'm looking forward to getting into that a bit more. But the reason I bought it in the first place was for the multiplayer,
of course,
and it doesn't disappoint. It's really good. I'm really, really impressed by it, and
awesome.
I'm gonna keep going and keep playing it and keep leveling up.
Excellent.
But there's only 3 multiplayer trophies.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah, no, it's actually.
For a multiplayer-centric game.
I'm kind of pleased about that.
For me, it's a little bit disappointing. Because, now I've got the 3 multiplayer trophies. The game has its hooks in me, so I want to keep playing. But yeah. I would have liked there to be a multiplayer trophy for regenning and, leveling up and upgrading your guns and all this and upgrading your titans.
Yeah.
Because there's more to it than just starting a multiplayer game, winning a multiplayer game and joining a user created faction, which they're the 3 multiplayer trophies in it.
Oh, right.
The rest of it is still single player stuff.
Yeah.
But it's a good game. It's going to be hard to platinum because, one of the trophies is, complete the campaign on expert.
Nice.
It's going to be bloody hard.
Yeah, sounds it.
It's going to be very difficult. But
on PS4, I noticed as well. Nice.
Yeah, I went for it on PS4. I don't know, because I was going to get it on Xbox, but I went for it on PS4.
Cool. Yeah, I might do the same. I'm play with you.
Yeah, it's really, really good.
Yeah.
Cool. Got some time for news to talk about in a little while.
Sweet.
Today, I've started Skyrim Remastered.
Nice.
Stepping out of my comfort zone. and jumping into a sort of a new world for me. But I've played a couple of hours so far this morning, well, going into this afternoon, and I'm very impressed.
Yeah, it sounds great.
I really like it. I'm learning in the minute still, but yeah, I really like it. I don't know why I didn't sort of get into it as much before. I think I've grown up as a gamer.
Maybe.
A little bit. But yeah, I think it's excellent. I love the combat. It's. I love the magic. I love the upgrade system. It's very cool.
Yeah.
The character customization is crazy.
Yes,
in the beginning, you can do everything, like from the size of your chin and the color of your eyes. And I've picked the Argonian.
Nice.
So right, I've learned the words. Like before I said Velociraptor Man, yeah. I remember on a couple of podcasts ago. But yeah, I've selected the Argonian, and I didn't want to just pick a normal, boring person.
That's fair.
I wanted to go for, if I'm going to be in this fantasy world, I want to be something outlandish and crazy. So yeah, I like that at the beginning when you meet that guy who like guides you through the first bit of the game. And he's like, yeah, he's my friend. And it's just like a lizard man just standing there. He's got red hair and blue eyes. And he's like, yeah, he's my friend. I look,
yeah, don't ask. It's a bit special.
Yeah. But it's, I'm really, really excited to go back into it. And I think that's, I just killed a big spider with fire.
Nice.
And, that rules.
Yeah. That's super cool.
I also did episode 3 of the Batman Telltale.
Oh, cool. Awesome.
Which was good. I'm enjoying the series.
It's fun. Still going to wait till the whole thing comes out.
Yeah,
out later,
it's going to come out. They're all going to be out before the end of the year.
Oh, cool.
So the final one will be out in December.
Excellent. Okay.
So you've got to play them all then.
Sweet.
Good times. Nice plan. I'm waiting for you at the end as well.
Nice.
Nice. We're back in the gaming news business this week.
Hooray.
We've got quite a lot to talk about.
Stuff happened.
Stuff has happened for the first time in about 3 months. So I mean, the quietest few months of all time. Like, a couple of bits and we've had to like wing it.
You pretty much
may just make things up.
Yeah.
Could a third entry into the Tomb Raider series be coming?
Ooh, probably.
According to a leak, the new game will be called Shadow of the Tomb Raider.
Oh, right, okay.
And may not be made by Crystal Dynamics, who have helmed Tomb Raider and Rise of the Tomb Raider.
Ooh.
It could be done by Eidos Montreal, who did Thief and most recently Deus Ex Mankind Divided.
Yeah, that's exciting, yeah.
Do you know how this was leaked?
How?
By somebody looking over the shoulder of somebody on a laptop looking at a Microsoft PowerPoint a Russian subway or something like that.
Bloody hell.
there's weird ways for information about games to get leaked. This is one of the weirdest.
Definitely. The way to find it, like a fan fiction, Shadow of the Tomb Raider.
Yeah. I mean, it could be legit.
Dark Lara Croft. With like red streaks in her hair.
Yeah, like emo Lara Croft.
Yeah, exactly.
She's listening to Cradle of Filth and she's hit a really dark time.
Didn't they have like an evil Lara Croft in one of the games?
Yeah, was it like Angel of Darkness, that one?
Something like that, yeah. Something weird.
That's a bad game as well.
Yeah, it is.
Was that like the first one that was on PS2?
I think so. I think it was PS2 one, yeah.
I think it was PS2 exclusive as well. I don't think it was anywhere else.
Yeah. That game sucks.
Oh, yeah, it sucks. Real bad. Interesting that Crystal Dynamics, I mean, we don't actually know how real this is because everyone sort of refused to comment.
Yeah, of course.
The weirdest leak ever. But I would quite like, if this is going to be a trilogy thing and then they're going to pass it on to someone else, I would rather see Crystal Dynamics get a third shot at it.
Yeah, sure. But again, it's always nice to have like a fresh perspective on it. So I don't know. It could be cool.
Be like someone other than Naughty Dog taking on Uncharted, though.
Yeah.
At this point, because I think the two that have been made by Crystal Dynamics so far have been great.
Yeah, I don't play the second one, actually. But yeah, I'm going to always have more Tomb Raider.
Yeah, sure. But, not that, you know, Eidos Montreal will do a bad job of it, because Mankind Divided is awesome.
Yeah, so, yeah. I'm excited.
Carrier billing is now available on Xbox One.
Mm.
If you don't know what that is, basically means if you don't want your credit card information to be stored on your console or on your Microsoft account, you can actually bill things to your mobile phone.
Yeah, I didn't even know it was a thing.
Yeah.
asked me what it was. I was like, what carrier billing was it? What?
Yeah, I've done it before using on PS4 when all the sort of craziness was sort of going on.
Oh, yeah.
So I've billed a few things to my PS4. This is why I mainly buy digital. because he's easy. And you haven't really got to have your credit card details stored, and I'm going to wait for your game to arrive. But I tried it out on Xbox One earlier on by purchasing Skyrim Remastered, and it works flawlessly and great.
Awesome.
They send you a code. You type that code into your Xbox. It says, we'll bill you, you know, on your mobile phone bill. And hey presto, game downloads.
Sweet.
So awesome. Works very well. So if you want to partake in carrier billing, you can now do so on Xbox One.
Excellent.
Good times.
Good stuff.
Okay, so EA had an earnings call. I think it was yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And there's some news that's come out of it. They've defended releasing Titanfall 2 so close to Battlefield 1 and Call of Duty.
Okay, because we're idiots.
I've got a direct quote here. Let me just pull this up on my iPad.
Ours has robots. That's different.
Yeah, pretty much.
Completely different game. What?
Okay, so EA CEO Andrew Wilson has said, Battlefield 1 and Titanfall 2 have some overlap. They fulfill very different motivations in what a player is looking for.
Yes.
We think there's three types of players, Wilson said. People that really love Battlefield and the kind of big strategic gameplay that will orient in that direction.
Mm-hmm.
The player that loves fast, fluid, kinetic gameplay of Titanfall 2 that really orient in that direction. The player that just has to play the two greatest shooters of the year and will buy both.
Yeah, that's true.
what I get from this is that they think that Titanfall and its futuristic gameplay may potentially sway the Call of Duty futuristic shooter fan.
Yeah, I guess. I mean, I'm more interested in Titanfall 2 than I am Call of Duty. Like, I'm probably am going to buy Titanfall 2. I'm probably not going to buy Call of Duty.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not really that bothered by Battlefield. So
yeah, I like the look of Battlefield, but it hasn't tempted me to buy it.
Yeah,
it looks beautiful and it's too big for me, and I'm not very good at the multiplayer on it.
Yeah, I've not been into like big, massive team shooters. I know about Overwatch a lot, but that's just because it's like fast and crazy.
But it's not open. The maps aren't open. Huge. They're like Titanfall maps and Call of Duty maps. It's probably not even as big as that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
With Battlefield, it's on a grander scale. It's like huge.
Yeah, you're right.
That's why I went opted for Titanfall over it.
Yeah.
I mean, I am going to buy Call of Duty this week, but that's only because I like Call of Duty. I'm a Call of Duty fan. I'm a fan of the franchise.
Yeah, that's fair.
And I play it every year, so it's, there are people that are only going to buy Call of Duty and are only going to buy Battlefield.
Yeah, of course.
So I do still think EA, to a certain degree, have sent Titanfall out to die a little in the middle, because it isn't going to sell anywhere near the numbers that they wanted from it.
Yeah.
And I think that's already been projected.
Yeah, I think, although we like Titanfall 1, I think some people were disappointed with it. So they're less likely to buy the Titanfall 2 and more likely to buy a game they already know they already like Call of Duty. Mm. It's like, what Titanfall?
Yeah, and this could be the end for Titanfall.
Yeah, that's sad. But I'm still going to buy it. I'm going to play it. I'm sorry for it.
Yeah, people should play it because it is truly excellent.
Yeah.
But again, the week after Battlefield and the week before Call of Duty, it just seems like a stupid decision for me.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, EA are defending its stance on it. And, if they're going to carry on the franchise because of their mistake, then fair play to them. But it is their fault.
It is a bit.
Yeah. Sticking with EA, they've said that they would delay Mass Effect Andromeda if need be.
Which means we're definitely delaying Mass Effect Andromeda.
Yeah, it's like they're setting it up.
Yeah.
We need to. Basically, they would delay the game if they felt it needed more time to make it better. The quote, right now, Mass Effect is tracking extremely well. The game looks beautiful and we're really pleased with its progress. However, you've seen we are willing to make moves in launch dates if we feel it's necessary to deliver the right player experience.
Right. We're not going to show you any of the game. We're not going to show you how good it's coming along. We're not going to show any gameplay. We're just going to show you some like screenshots from behind some guy's head.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah.
To further the quote, if the game is not where BioWare wants it to be, the developer could delay it with EA's blessing. The delay could be a week, or it could be 3 or 4 or 5 months, if need be.
Or a year, or 2 years, or 3 years, or count up.
Electronic Arts, if you are willing to delay launch dates then maybe you should have thought that way about Titanfall.
Maybe.
Delay it to early next year when people have maybe, when both Call of Duty and Battlefield are both simmering down and people are looking for a new experience.
Maybe yeah.
You should have done that.
Maybe.
I don't know if this directly says that it's going to get delayed, but
it pretty
the,
much
the
is.
Potential is there for it to be delayed.
Yeah, expect delays. I don't know when it's due for release, is it?
March, I think?
March? That's never, sure it's not coming in March, I'm sorry.
Yeah, but fact, it might not be March, I might have made that up, but it's definitely due next year, isn't it?
Yeah, I'll have a look quickly.
Yeah, it's... if it is due in March, it's not coming in March. There's no way it's coming in March.
No way. Oh, yep, March 2017.
Oh, it is due March.
Yep, not happening.
Oh, no way. Not
absolutely
4 months.
Not. No, nope. We've seen nothing of it. Some crappy...
We've seen that one bit when the PlayStation Pro was unveiled in that terrible press conference.
Yeah.
We just saw that guy jumping, didn't we?
Yeah. You can jump in Mass Effect. That's always
really?
My God.
What, the game looks beautiful? Who would have known?
Yeah.
Expected it to look like crap.
Yeah, there's no way coming in March. I'm sorry, people. Expecting... So Christmas next year at the earliest.
You think?
Yeah. I'm willing to put my house on it. I won't, but I won't.
Yeah, well, yeah. Yeah. Star Wars Battlefront 2 is coming during the fall of 2017.
Oh, cool.
We're sticking with EA here. When asked about it, he said it was going to be a year from now. We're working very hard on making sure that it is an extremely deep and engaging offering.
Right.
The game will have bigger and better worlds. And will have content from the new movies, though he didn't name any outright.
Right, that day.
Okay. Apparently EA plans to release one new Star Wars game every year for the next 3 or 4 years.
Right, okay.
No brainer to release Star Wars Battlefront 2.
Yeah, I mean, I think especially right now.
Shipped 14 million copies.
Bloody hell. Yeah, it's like now's the time to strike with Star Wars, isn't it? It's like all these new movies coming out. It's like
yeah, there's going to be at least one a year. So, I mean, as well as games, you're going to get... movies as well, because Rogue One comes out next month or the month after. Oh, no, next month it comes out.
Cool.
We're in November now, aren't we?
So, we are.
Yeah, and then you've got Star Wars episode... whatever. The sequel to the Force Awakens, anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, Star Trek
5. Yeah.
What else?
Starring John Luke Skywalker. In the USS Millennium Falcon.
So yeah, that, it's a no-brainer for them to bring that out.
Yeah, of course. I'm still not going to play it, but yeah.
Yeah, I will play it, because I love Battlefront, but...
yeah, that's fair.
Because it's a simple shooter. It's
yeah,
not
exactly.
Like, it's not sprawling like Battlefront.
Yeah, it's
no,
like...
Battlefield, sorry.
Yeah, Battlefield for dummies.
It is, yeah.
Pretty much.
Battlefield for geeks.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, like me. The new Xbox codename Scorpio will play all of your Xbox One games, of course.
Of course.
But even the Xbox 360 backwards compatible games.
Ooh.
So it's going to cater for the whole family.
Good.
Yeah, good times. I think this is fairly unsurprising.
Yeah.
They did say that they didn't want to alienate anybody.
Yeah. I think it's going to be like the PS4 Pro, it's just a more powerful Xbox One.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
We don't really know nothing about it still.
Pretty much, yeah.
I think we will. I think news will start to filter out.
Yeah.
Probably not this year, but very early next year, I would have thought now.
Yeah, I'd imagine so, yeah.
Yeah. I'm reserving whether I'm going to buy it or not yet.
Yeah.
It really depends what it is.
Yeah, it's just going to be like a PS4 Pro, but Xbox.
Yeah, I don't need the PS4 Pro right now.
No, same.
In fact, I don't really need it at all.
No.
Until... I don't really want to buy a 4K TV until gaming dictates that I have to.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe like, PS5 comes out, maybe then.
Yeah, bought a HD TV for Xbox 360 because HD gaming was starting to come in. I'm like,
exactly.
Oh, okay. I've been playing on a bloody huge backed TV for Xbox 360, but now I've seen it on a HD TV. Now, okay, that's the way forward.
Yeah, same here.
And until, you know, I really see that this is, you know, we have to have it. Until the next console says 4K gaming on it, like when Xbox 360 came out, I said HD gaming on it.
Yeah.
But that's when I'll make that jump, I think.
Yeah, same here. I was only just bought my TV like fairly recently when I moved in.
Yeah, so I don't really care about watching movies and TV in 4K. Couldn't care less.
Yeah,
I want to watch football in 4K. Not bothered.
Yeah.
But gaming, you know, that's when it dictates that I have to, that's when I'll go for it.
Yeah, because right now I think things run natively at 4K because you'd need like a crazy powerful machine stronger than what the PS4 Pro is. So it's more going to be upscaled, which still looks great, but not as good.
Yeah.
So, yeah, wait until next gen, I think, for me. Yeah. personally.
Also, I think like 4K TVs are really aimed at the wrong people at the minute. Like you see, I saw an electronics company advertising the new Sony or a new LG TV.
Oh yeah.
And like it was a husband and wife picking it up, and I was like, you've not really watching 4K movies and.
No, like watching Shrek in 4K.
Yeah, so I think it's really, this sort of technology is aimed at gamers.
I think so. Right now, anyway.
And people who are really anal about watching 4K Blu-rays.
Yeah. It's like, when TV starts running in 4K, that's when it'll get huge, I think.
Yeah, because I don't think you can get BBC in 4K at the minute.
No,
but
so.
You can get Sky Sports in 4K. Well, select matches and stuff in 4K.
Yeah,
but you can't watch WWE in 4K.
No, it's a shame.
Until everything is 4K. It's like when I remember when WWE went HD and they just made a massive thing of it.
Yeah, they're like WWE HD in the corner. Like, oh, yeah, everything's HD. Whoa,
it's like whoa, we're in the future. It's high definition. We can see Shawn Michaels' wrinkles.
Yeah, see every bead of sweat going down.
Yeah,
half naked men's.
But eventually, I mean, eventually 4K will start to trickle in. You'll get WWE 4K and then
have
it in the corner and all that stuff. And, you know, then I think normal households will, start to buy 4K TVs and all that sort of stuff.
Absolutely.
But for now, no.
Yes, 2-2.
Production of Wii U consoles is ending on the 4th of November, and it has been confirmed by a rep from Nintendo of America.
Yes.
Unsurprising.
Unsurprising, yes.
With the Switch coming.
Yep, Switch has been announced coming early next year. It's a no-brainer, really, isn't it? Again, it's like,
The
console's not selling, why make more?
Yeah, that's it. It's really sad.
It is sad.
I'm still a firm fan of the Wii U.
Yeah, I love the Wii U.
And I'm sad that it didn't take off the way that it probably should have done.
Yeah.
But again, this is down to marketing, and it was marketed very poorly.
Yeah, I agree. We used to play some Wii U games on YouTube.
Yeah, I mean, it was marketed as... I don't even know what it was marketed as. It was, like, was it marketed as the follow-up to the Wii? Or?
It was announced in a really weird way. It's like people didn't know what it was because they talked about the controller and people were like, oh, is this a new controller for the Wii? Is this like an upgraded version of the Wii? Do we really need... Is it a new console at all? But I thought it was just... When I first saw the announcement, I thought it was just a new controller. I was like, oh, that's weird. And then later it was like, oh, it's actually a console. Because I don't think they even showed the console in the announcement. It was just like, well, look at this cool controller. It's a touchscreen and stuff. It's like, okay...
Yeah,
and then eventually it's like, oh no, actually it's a new console, it's more powerful, etc.
But then again, to like, because Wii was very much aimed at a casual audience, and because of that casual audience and the fact that it was novelty to use at parties and family gatherings and stuff like that, the Wii sold a ton.
Yeah, of course.
Like just so much.
So much.
And the marketing with the Wii just confused everything.
Yeah, I think they tried to capitalize on the success of the Wii. But yeah, it really kind of fell flat in his face because nobody knew what it was. It's like, do we really need this? No, we've got a Wii. Who cares?
I hope the Switch doesn't follow the same pattern. I
hope so.
It's different. It's got a different name. It doesn't have Wii in the name.
Yeah.
So this already got... That already beats the Wii U for me.
Yeah, because... the trailer was very good, I thought. It's like showing you everything they can do, what the novelty of it is, and why you need it.
And it also showed that it's going to have more support from third parties too.
Yeah, yeah. It's great.
So, it is sad that the Wii never took off, but... unsurprising due to Nintendo's stubborn and stupid way of promoting things.
Yeah. I was speaking of last week when you mentioned it. You mentioned that EA wasn't on the big list of developers. It said it is.
Oh, it is.
Isn't it? Yeah. There's a correction from last week.
That's me being blind. Apologies. There's been a huge 5-gig patch for Drive Club.
Oh, yeah.
Giving you 15 new free tracks and some cars. And it's free. And in the developer notes, it basically thanks everybody for supporting Drive Club and just gives a little farewell message.
Oh, that's nice.
So if you are a Drive Club fan, it basically gives you some new tracks, some of which were included in Drive Club VR that weren't tracks in the original Drive Club. So
cool.
This game, from troubled beginnings to what it is now, it's a real success story, I think.
Yeah, I think so. People love that game.
Yeah, people love that game, and I'm sure they'll really love this, the final patch.
Yeah.
And it's free as well. It's not part of the season pass or anything like that. It's just free for everybody.
Excellent.
And it's nice that they've included, sort of like a thank you in the...
Yeah, it's nice.
In the patch notes as well.
Glossy.
Speaking of patch notes, how ridiculous was the WWE 2K17 patch?
It's so huge. Jesus Christ.
I'm not even sure what it's done.
Yeah, I've really not noticed the whole thing, a whole lot of difference, honestly. It's like... I was reading through it. I think they fixed like a couple of bugs people were complaining about. But we had tons of like graphical bugs on our stream.
Yeah, we did, yeah.
It's like, oh, okay. Yeah. Game Max is going through some stuff that they fixed. It's like, oh, okay, cool, so I've fixed some stuff, but I don't think they've really improved it a whole lot.
No, I don't think they have either.
I don't know. Still 3.5 stars.
Yep.
From my view.
PlayStation VR sales are on track, according to Sony.
Good.
On course to sell up to 2.6 million units by the end of 2016.
Nice.
That's good.
It's very good, yeah.
We had a little conversation about PlayStation VR before we started recording today. And people are sort of having a go at VR. Basically, we determined that it's the same as like the console wars. If you don't own both, you automatically hate the one that you don't own.
Yeah,
of course. Like people who own PS4s are like very fanboy towards PS4s and just hate the Xbox One with all
how
of
dare
them
they
right.
have a different console than me.
Oh, let's laugh at Xbox One for no real reason. Yeah, you just hate it because you don't own it.
It looks weird that...
Because one of our Twitter followers tweeted me earlier on because I when I tweeted that I was going to stream Batman Arkham VR. Okay. He was like, oh, you're going to stream all 23 minutes of the VR fad's best game.
Mm.
And I just sort of thought, why do you hate this? Like, it's like this is like an evolution of gaming.
Yeah, like VR is brand new. Developers are still figuring it out. They don't know. They're figuring out what works, what doesn't work. We're only going to get short games for the time being. It's like, it's brand new technology. You can't expect these massive, amazing 100-hour games which last forever and completely immerse you just yet. They'll come, I'm sure, eventually, in a few years, maybe.
Of course.
But right now...
As the technology develops, the games will develop. But at the minute, I don't want a Skyrim experience on VR.
Exactly, yeah.
I couldn't deal with it for a start.
Exactly. I'm perfectly happy heading balls into a goal or...
Exactly.
...being Batman for half an hour.
Like, he also cool. said that, you know, there's no fun... There's no fun games. Well,
there's so many fun games.
There's
dude.
So many fun games like
Headmaster, Batman,
Sports Bar.
Yeah, Sports Bar.
Until Dawn.
Until Dawn. Tumble VR.
Yeah. So, all right. So we've just named six there.
Everything was a demo.
Yeah. But
that's Super Hypercube.
This isn't gonna sort of, which is brilliant by the way. I have played it now and it's superb.
Awesome.
But if you can't, you know, if you've not tried it for whatever reason, if whether it's you can't afford it. Or you've not had a chance to try it at a friend's house or...
An Xbox One.
Or you own an Xbox One or, you know, anything. It doesn't give you reason to hate on it. At least try the technology. If you've tried it and then you hate it, fine.
Yeah, fine.
But if it's a case that you can't afford it or you are, you know, so stuck in your ways that you don't want to try it and are ignorant to it, then you shouldn't really have cause to hate it.
Yeah, it's like when the Wii came out, it's like, oh, motion controls, casual fans ruining in gaming. Oh, how dare they, these new casual fans, start playing video games, blah.
Yeah, and then these are the same people at their family gatherings playing Wii bowling are being real competitive about it.
Yeah, he's like, just let them have the fun. I like the Wii, it's awesome.
Yeah, but that's the main thing, it's bringing in a different audience.
Exactly, yeah.
Like, I sat Lottie's mum down with Resident Evil Kitchen Demo.
Oh, nice.
Right, and she doesn't get scared by anything. Me and Lottie were like, oh, this is going to be amazing. She's going to shit herself. And she was sat there and she was like, this is amazing. Wow. And like, she's a mum, not a gamer.
Yeah, yeah.
And she was like, that was just really amazing. Like a really amazing experience. And I stuck her on the VR Worlds demo with the sea stuff.
Oh, yeah, the fish tank thing, yeah.
And she was like, this is just amazing.
Cool.
And apparently she was talking about it for the rest of the day.
Awesome.
So it's like, it gives... I mean, these sort of people wouldn't want to sit in front of Titanfall.
Exactly, yeah.
They want to sit in front of Skyrim and be like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah. It's like the more people play games, the better game will be, yeah.
Yeah, it's better for the gaming industry. It's better for us as gamers. And it's nice to see new people coming in and playing games.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Like, I've loved showing VR off to people.
Yeah,
it's just great. Like, I loved seeing people playing the Wii and getting enjoyment out of it who aren't gamers.
Exactly, yeah. Just, it's fun. Gaming is fun. Full stop.
And that's what it should be.
It should be, yeah.
And it has to evolve.
Yeah. New and different experiences help, as I said, help the gaming industry grow and get better and better. And if you don't like it, that's fine. But don't hate on people who are having fun with it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
What's the point? Don't hate.
Don't hate. Haters gonna hate.
Haters gonna hate.
Hate. Taylor Swift reference.
Oh, okay.
You're welcome.
I knew that.
Sure.
Taylor Swift.
Do you not like Taylor Swift?
It's fine, I guess. Right, okay. I don't know.
You don't dislike her?
I don't dislike it, no. It's just music, yeah.
She has long legs.
Yeah.
Which is lovely.
Great. Right, I'll take your word for it.
Okay, fine.
I know she is. Like, which one is she? Oh, yeah, the tall one.
She's pretty tall.
Yeah.
Like her legs are as tall as you.
Probably. Hello, Taylor Swift. Look out.
That'd be a good view.
Eh?
That'd be a good view.
It probably would be, yeah. Anyway.
Finn.
Yes.
If I wanted to buy games this month, but I wasn't sure what was coming out, would anybody be able to tell me?
Well, I'm glad you asked. I have a list right here, just as it happens.
Oh, okay. That's good. A coincidence.
Yes. Let's go through the games of November. The list.
You just made the list.
You just made the list.
Of games coming out this month.
Right, so
on the new jingle for this section of the first podcast of every month.
Yes, followed by a single air horn. Right. So on November 1st, we have, out now, Owlboy on PC, which is like a, kind of like a retro inspired Metroidvania kind of thing. It's I'm Super Minty.
Okay.
It's a game called Root Letter on PS4 and PS Vita. Shrug. A game called Seraph on Xbox One, PS4, and PC.
And then the indie game. What are these games?
I don't know. Let's have a look, actually.
Seraph?
Like, yeah, I guess it's like a little indie game kind of thing. Let's have a look. There's literally no information on GameSpot about it.
Oh, good.
So, it's a game that exists. Also, the November 1st, Super Dungeon Bros. On PS4, Xbox One, and PC, which is like a dungeon crawler multiplayer thing. Looks kind of fun, actually.
Oh, I heard about this, actually. The idea of it does sound pretty fun.
Yeah, it's fun. Fun co-op game. Maybe it's there on one of our co-op streams.
Yeah, sure.
What else have we got? November 4th, we have a little game called, obscure game called Call of Duty Infinite Warfare.
Call of Duty?
Yeah, that's a bit weird. I haven't really heard of it.
This must be a new franchise.
Yeah, like an indie developed game. Oh, yeah, I'm not really interested. Of course, we can all call these. Also, November 4th, a game I'll never understand why it's popular, but it is Football Manager 2017. Why?
I bought last year's Football Manager, and it is very addictive, but it's, to be honest, I'm not going to get this year's one. I'm bored of it. I'd rather play football on FIFA or Pro Evo or something like that.
Yeah.
But it's super massive.
Yeah, there are people out there who only ever play Football Manager games, and it's like, I don't understand the appeal. If you're playing football, again, yeah, sure, I get it, fine.
This goes back to what we were just talking about.
Yeah, same thing
with people. This is something that people are into and not necessarily into Call of Duty or Titanfall.
Yeah.
Saying that people who play Football Manager are definitely into Call of Duty.
Probably, yeah. But yeah, it's fine. Mario Party Star Rush on 3DS.
But still making those games.
Still making them. Mario Party's awesome.
Okay. Yeah, I agree. I like Mario Party.
Yeah, we should play some on YouTube.
Do you have the Wii U version?
I don't, but I can get it.
Was there a Wii U version?
Yep, the Wii U version. It wasn't that great, but still fun.
Sure.
Wasn't good, but like buy the old ones on like Virtual Console.
Oh, can you?
Oh, yeah. We'll play those. Cool. Expect those soon. Also have Sword Art Online Hollow Realization for PS4 and Vita.
Is that a U game? Oh. It sounds like a U game.
Yeah, it's... I like Sword Art Online, the anime, most of it. But I don't know, the games aren't that great, I don't think.
Right,
in my opinion. There are people out there who like them, so who am I to judge?
Sure.
On November 8th, we have Eagle Flight on PlayStation VR.
Okay, this looks pretty cool. I remember seeing the demo for it at E3 this year.
Yeah, yeah.
People trying it out, it looks great.
Yeah, they can see. Fun to try.
It's like a racing game, isn't it?
I think so, yeah, pretty much. Yeah. Except you're like an eagle flying over like a town or something.
Yeah.
We have a Harvest Moon Sky Tree Village on 3DS on November 8th. That was an exciting one. Robinson the Journey on PlayStation VR.
Oh, yeah. This is one that is right up my street.
Same.
Simply because it's dinosaurs.
Dinosaurs
and
VR.
It looks better. But this is a full price game.
It is, yeah.
But I don't understand how it's going to work. And I think it's an analog stick one.
I think
so. It's a DualShock one.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure how the traversal is going to work.
Yeah. Weird one. We'll see.
Because if it's if it's going to be a massive game, then here is your first eight-hour experience or whatever.
Yeah.
I don't see it being that way, though.
No, we'll see.
I don't know what to expect. I love dinosaurs.
Yeah, yeah. Wait for reviews on that one. November 10th, big day, PlayStation 4 Pro comes out.
I'd actually forgotten, to be honest. The phone's already out. That's how much I care about PlayStation Pro at this point.
Yeah, I'm not too bothered personally, but a lot of people out there are excited, so good for them.
Yeah, fair enough.
There's a game called Tyranny on November 10th on PC.
Sure.
Let's see
PC what. Nerds, all of that.
Let's see what it's about. Once again, very little information about it.
Ah, good.
Who even knows?
GameSpot has no information on games.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah, GameSpot.
Thanks for the list, though.
Yeah, thanks for the list. On November 11th, we have Dishonored 2 on Xbox One, PS4, and PC.
That's a big one. There's some big games this month.
Yeah, big games. Yeah, I'm excited for that. I don't know if I buy day one, but I will definitely play it, buy and play it at some point.
Yeah, I won't get it, but because I didn't really like the first one, but no, it's fine.
Yeah. Also, a game called Silence on PC. Let's see what information they have on this one. I'm going to guess very little. Oh, that's the full title, Silence the Whispered World 2. We'll take players back to Silence, a world made of dreams. We accompany Noah, a teenager who... No one gets.
That sounds like garbage.
Pretty much. we have Overcooked Gourmet Edition on Xbox One and PC. PS4, rather.
Hang on, what's this?
I don't know. Let's have a look.
Is this just on disc? Is that what this is?
Oh, it could be, actually. Yeah, that's a good point. Good point. Let's have a look. Oh, click on it to take you to the Overcooked page. So, yeah, I have no idea.
Oh, okay. I imagine because it didn't get a disc release before, it's just been digital, so I know it was coming out on disc, and maybe they've just sort of... I don't think it has DLC.
I don't think so. Yeah, we'll just put this all in, yeah. Good point.
We'll get back on that next week, by the way.
Yeah, we'll figure it out. Also on the same day, Watch Dogs 2, Xbox One and PS4.
Yeah, I am interested in this. It looks cool. I think I'm going to wait, though. I'm going to wait for reviews because the last one upset me, so...
Yeah, I want to wait for
it,
I think.
It looks cool. It looks better.
Yeah.
We'll see if they've learned from the mistakes.
Hope so. Also on the same day, the new series of The Walking Dead Telltale, A New Frontier, Episode 1.
Is that Season 3?
I think so.
Yeah, okay.
It starts Clementine and I think it's some other guy.
Oh, yeah, okay.
It's cool. I'm looking forward to that. I'd love the first two.
Yeah, I haven't played the second one yet, actually. I need to.
It's great.
Is there a Platinum on the PS4 version?
Not in the second one for some reason. I'll only do the disc. I've got it.
Oh, have you got it?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay, cool.
I'll get you right next time. Welcome to that on literally everything. Xbox One, Xbox 360, PS4, PS4 again. That's best to say PS4.
Your phone.
Your phone.
Yeah, literally everything.
Your lap, your bloody calculator. and it's November 17th, we have Assassin's Creed Ezio Collection.
That'll be cool. There's a lot of people that are going to be excited for that because they're probably the best ones.
Oh, yeah. Two and Brotherhood were great.
And Brotherhood are awesome. What's the other one that you get with it?
What the hell was it? Brotherhood. I can't remember. I played it. I liked it. I'll get back to you.
Okay.
What's the same day? Planet Coaster on PC.
Planet what?
Coaster. I think it's like a Roller Coaster Tycoon kind of thing. Which is fine.
People still play those games.
Yeah, they were super popular.
So it's like there's like so many farming games out at the minute.
Oh god,
who the hell is playing Farming Simulator? There's one at the minute that's like, it's like a chopping down trees one. I can't remember what it's called, Forester Simulator or something like that. Same company, obviously.
Yeah,
but these are boring.
Yeah,
like clearly... I played Goat Simulator and it was funny for about 5 minutes, but then it's crap after that.
Yeah, but I don't know. People keep making this. Like they're making money from it.
Bus Simulator on PC.
Yeah. But apparently, Euro Truck Simulator is quite good for some reason.
No truck game will ever be as good as 18 Wheeler on the Dreamcast.
Oh, yeah.
What a wonderful game. You have it because I gave it to you.
Yeah, I do.
But it's brilliant.
Cool. I played it.
You definitely play it. It's awesome.
Cool. November 18th, another big day. Pokemon Sun and Moon on 3DS.
That's a big one. I'm going to get it my nephew for Christmas.
Sweet.
He wants a 2DS, so I'm going to get him the Pokemon Sun and Moon 2DS.
Nice.
He won't listen to this podcast, so it's fine. But cool. I'm going to get this like a bundle. It's like quite cheap. It's like 70 quid.
Oh, nice.
Which means like the game, you're paying like 30 quid for the 2DS, really.
Nice. That's awesome. I'm going to buy that for myself for Christmas.
Cool.
Also on the same day, Killing Floor 2 on PS4 and PC.
Yeah.
First one was a PC exclusive, so it's cool to see it coming to console.
It's a cheap game as well.
Yeah. It's like basically kind of like Left 4 Dead kind of thing, I think. Like trying to get to objectives while trying to survive zombies and stuff, I think.
Okay.
We have the Amnesia Collection coming to PS4, which is exciting.
Is it actually exciting?
Yeah, spooky horror games. First one was great. I loved Amnesia 1.
Okay.
I knew the best Amnesia. First game in the long time to actually scare me. Like, I was legitimately scared to play it for a while.
Oh.
Just very atmospheric and cool. Play it. Definitely play it if you haven't played it. Also on the same day, a game you're excited for definite, a game called We Sing, on Xbox One and PS4.
Oh, is it? You know, this is going to sound bad, but for a second I thought it was some sort of Chinese game.
We Sing.
I didn't even register that it was a singing game.
That's pretty funny.
We Sing, set in Beijing in the 1980s.
Oh, God.
No, it's a group of ragtag karaoke singers.
Yeah. That's awesome. That's going to be one of our games when we start making games.
Yeah, we see.
Bits and bits and bobs, yeah. Oh, God. November 29th, we have Darksiders Warmaster Edition.
Which is not cool. Out yet?
Nope, the second one is out.
This is by THQ Nordic, isn't it? Who are being acting very strangely. Like they're buying up all these IPs that are crap and worthless, basically.
Darksiders aren't crap. I love Darksiders.
No, Darksiders is fine. But it's nothing better than fine. It's not exactly a groundbreaking... People love Darksiders, and that's fine. But, they're buying up other franchises. I don't know if you've seen this. But, they're buying up different franchises, and I don't know what they're going to do. This studio almost seems destined to fail to me.
No, they do stuff.
Yeah, no, cool. But why change your name to THQ? It's like a laughing stock.
No. THQ, people like THQ. They just got unlucky, and that's I don't know. Lost a bunch of money.
Stop sticking up for THQ.
I like THQ. Red Faction.
Yeah, but that's not relevant anymore.
Yes, it is.
If they brought a new game out now, it'd bomb massively, wouldn't it?
Yeah. But the last one was also breaking all the buildings down and collapsing and you smash stuff. Don't look at me like that. November 29th. We also have a game I'm the super hyped for and you're going to buy as well, we just said. Final Fantasy 15.
Oh, hell yeah. I'm super looking forward to this.
Yeah.
This isn't, I'm not a Final Fantasy guy. Had Final Fantasy VII on my PS1. I was so confused by it because I was a dumb kid. I had no idea. I just wanted to play Die Hard Trilogy. but this I'm super stoked for. I played the demo, loved the demo, loved the free flow combat. And yeah.
It's great. I'm so hyped for this. Recently,
I hope it doesn't suck. That's the thing. Hope it doesn't suck.
After it will.
All the problems that it's gone through in the last Christ knows however long it's been made.
Yeah.
It's been being made since I was playing Final Fantasy VII.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. And that was 10 years ago, Final Fantasy versus 13. And I'm super excited for it.
I'm looking forward to it. That's why I've not bought World of Final Fantasy. That's why I'm going to hold out for Final Fantasy 15.
Makes sense.
Final Fantasy fix.
Yes. I've got to try and speed through World of Final Fantasy before that comes out. They recently released a CG trailer for it, which is super awesome and cool. I highly recommend checking it out. Also on the same day, the crew calling all units on Xbox One, PS4, and PC.
Sure. Wow, they're still getting stuff out of that game?
Probably.
Is that another expansion?
I actually don't know. Let's have a look. That linked me to a bloody trailer for it. Don't want that. Who knows?
All right, okay. it's coming and that's it.
It could be just like a bundler with the game and all DLC and all that. Maybe.
God, that'd be like the third one.
Would it?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
The third version of that game, because they brought out Wild Run,
which was
the original game and the Wild Run DLC packaged in one. And then if they're going to do this, I imagine it's going to have the crew Wild Run and whatever the hell that's called again.
Yeah. Weird. Okay. And also on the same day, Watch Dogs 2 comes out on PC. And that's it.
Right. Tune in next month for You Just Made the List!
You Just Made the List!
Of games out this month.
Everyone. I'll add it in post.
Alright, let's talk wrestling.
Okay.
Hell in a Cell was this past Sunday.
It was.
I don't have the results in front of me.
I do.
Tell me about the show. What did you think to it?
It was...
While you talk, I'm just going to walk over here.
Okay. It was fine. It was good. And good matches. And wasn't super great. It was better than the Clash of Champions. But still not amazing. Not as good as whatever the SmackDown last one was. No mercy.
No mercy.
But, it's fine. It's a good watch. Good night of wrestling.
It was okay. I liked Reigns versus Rusev.
Yeah.
I thought they put it all on the line, and it was much better than I had any expectations for.
Yeah, same.
Because we weren't hyped for it at all. We were like,
We ain't hype.
we just couldn't care less about that match. They went at it and it was awesome.
Yeah, it's great. I really liked the spot where he had Roman Reigns on the steps and he had the chain and the accolade. Super cool. But then just Reigns got stood up and
it might be time to retire the accolade now because if I don't know what difference on the stairs makes anyway, but if you can't win when he's got a chain wrapped around his face, it might be time to look for a new finishing move.
Yeah. It did look cool, but Reigns stood up.
Yeah, it was awesome, yeah. Really good match.
Yeah, really good match. Reigns just stood up, did a smear drop on the steps, it was super painful. And
then a massive spear,
and you know, it. Lol, Reigns wins. this is why people don't like Reigns.
The thing is, Reigns isn't a bad wrestler.
He's not, it's fine.
We talked about this on the stream, didn't we? When we were sort of like, people give Reigns a hard time, but then these are the same idiots that like Brock Lesnar and all he does is suplexes.
Yeah, exactly.
Puts no creative work into his matches, just loves a suplex.
Yeah, and then Trump seeing Punk during cruiserweight matches.
Great.
Speaking of, there was a very cool tag team match on the pre-show.
Which I didn't watch, actually.
No, it was great. I recommend it. Lots of high-flying. Xin Kar was showing off his crazy strength, lifting up people in one arm. Jesus Christ. Ultimate fighter, indeed. We made a bet on the stream of who would win. I said the good guys would win. You said the bad guys would win. Good guys won. Yay. Point for me.
Right, okay. You're gonna hammer me on this. I was watching the card thinking, Jesus Christ.
So that's a point for me. We also both said Reigns would win on Reigns vs. Rusev. Of course, he did. So that's 2 points for me, 1 point for Sonny. What next? Bayley versus Dana. It was fine. It served its purpose.
It was okay. I said Dana would win, I believe.
You did.
But I'm standing by the fact that I still think that would have been the right decision.
Okay.
Just because Dana needs that sort of heel heat right now.
Yeah, she does.
But I'm happy that Bayley win. I like Bayley a lot. So it was an okay match. It was just okay.
Yeah. Also, someone said during the stream that Dana really needs new ring attire. She came out in new ring attire.
She didn't look, I don't want to use the word fat, but fat. She didn't look fat. She looked fat before, but she isn't at all.
No.
She's like
buff,
in
huge.
Incredible shape.
Awesome.
But the ring attire was not very flattering that she was wearing before.
Oh, so.
I like Dana. She's fine.
Yeah, Dana as well. She's good. She's improving slowly. But she is improving.
Very slowly.
After that, we had Enzo and Cass versus The Club. Or Gallows and Anderson, that's called now, I guess.
They're still wearing the club t-shirts, so yeah. Maybe they...
I think the original plan was probably to have Finn Balor have something to do with them, maybe, and then Finn Balor injured, so now they're kind of flanding around and not doing much.
Yeah.
So started off with, like, Enzo and Cass talking, words, how are you doing? and it was a weird match, I thought. But Enzo and Cass had, like, all the offense during the match, and then, like, right at the end, the club hit their magic killer and won. Which I'm glad the club won, because they need
it. Yeah.
Just weird.
Yeah, I'm glad the club won. What do we have as far as results go there?
I said Andrew and Cash would win. You said the club would win, so that's a point to you. Which brings us to 3-2 to me still.
Yeah, I'm going to be tailing along this whole pay-per-view.
Perhaps.
The club needed that win, by the way.
They did. And then they kind of ruined it on Monday.
Oh, yeah, they definitely did, yeah.
They absolutely ruined it. God, we'll get to that. And then we had Owens versus Seth in the cage. Which meant the main event was going to be Sasha versus Charlotte. Ooh.
Mm.
But Owens versus Seth. Probably the match of the night for me. Awesome match. Owens was targeting like Seth's back the whole match, which made sense. Like, ripped off the tape he had in his back.
Everyone's wearing that tape right now.
Everyone is, yeah. Just blowing off Cesaro.
Yeah. He's got rolls and rolls of it, so I'm sure it's fine.
Yeah. Yeah, some cool spots on there. So like a cannonball against the cage. Ref got blasted with a fire extinguisher. He got taken out, and then Kushaga ran in. I think someone called during the live stream. like the ref would get injured and then someone went in. No Triple H, which I thought would happen. But that's fine, I guess.
Yeah, I've given up on Triple H now. I don't know what the deal is.
Yeah. But Jericho's
we'll get an explanation eventually when it does come to that build up for Triple H versus Seth, which is definitely going to happen.
It'll definitely happen, yep. For sure. It's a cool spot where they had like two tables stacked up on each other. One was like leant against the cage and like, Seth powerbombed Kevin Owens through it. Crazy strength, like lifting him up, deadlifts. Don't know how he did that. With supposedly a bad back. But, yeah.
It's the miracle of wrestling.
It's the miracle of wrestling.
It is, yeah.
Yeah. And it looked great as well. Super painful and cool.
Yeah, I don't think there was any doubt that these guys were going to put on a great show.
Yeah.
I could really do without the Jericho interference.
Okay.
Because, I mean, you know, excuse me. I don't know where they're going with Owen's character. Is he going to be the cheap heel champion who wins by shenanigans all the time?
Didn't go that way.
But but he shouldn't be that. Like
really.
In NXT, he was just destroying people.
Yeah, yeah.
Like Joe is right now.
Exactly, yeah.
But I don't know. I'm glad Owen's kept the belt, and I don't think there was any doubt that he was going to.
No. It looked like Seth had the upper hand, but then they both, numbers game got the better of him, and like both teamed up on him with chairs and stuff. And got hit with a pop-up power bomb, and yeah, that was it. Threw some chairs, like set up some two chairs, and two chairs, like painful as well. Ouch. Yeah, both had Owens to win, because, of course,
that's a point to us.
Yeah. 4-3 to me. Then we had TJ Perkins versus Brian Kendrick. which was a great match. Not that you would know it listening to this god-awful crowd. Once again, who are these people who come to wrestling events just to boo wrestling? It's I don't get it.
Again, like I said this on the stream, they want flipping and flopping from the cruiserweights. They want... Like Brian Kendrick's not a flippy-flappy wrestler.
Flippy-flappy.
Flippy-flappy. You know, he's a technician, but what makes him a cruiserweight is his weight.
Exactly, yeah, pretty much.
Like TJ Perkins is, like, he can do the flying stuff and, you know, did.
Yeah.
Like, but, I don't know, these crowds, man, at the minute, they're very disrespectful. That's the most polite term I can use for them. Because it's just frustrating. Because I'm seriously rooting for the cruiserweights. Like, I really want them to do well. I want them to have a prominent spot on the show. And because they deserve to. Yeah. They're superb athletes, great wrestlers, and they put on great matches. But people just want to see flipping and flapping.
Pretty much. But that was a great match.
Good match, yeah.
I liked it a lot. Kendrick ended up winning via shenanigans. He faked an injury. I think he went for like sliced bread number two and landed on his knees. Oh, my knees hurt. Oh. Mm. And TJ Perkins went to help him. And then ate a headbutt. And he put in like the bully choke. It's not the Gavin Tuck, it's the bully choke. TJP tapped out.
Yeah, I'm not mad at it because originally I was really against TJP dropping the title, but seeing how good Brian Kendrick is at the minute,
so good.
I think this feud has definitely got life in it.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, going into the end of the year, so I'm happy that Kendrick has won it.
Yep.
And I think TJP will be strong still going forward. So I've rethought it and I'm not mad at it anymore. But I did say TJP would win because I didn't think they would take the belt off him yet. But
you did?
I was wrong.
I said Kendrick would win. I was right again. Yay. It's 5-3 to me.
Steaming away.
But yeah, I love Kendrick character. It's just so good.
Very good. I don't know if you saw Raw Talk after the awful.
I thought Smack is good. It makes sense. Then they're like, oh, we need something like that. War Talk. Yeah.
Like, Raw now is going to be 5 hours.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Pre-show Raw and Raw Talk. That's like 5 hours of Raw. It's like
too much.
3 hours of Raw is too much.
Yeah, seriously.
He was on that and he had like a little sort of war of words with Booker T.
Yeah, I did see that.
Which was really cool.
Yeah.
I'm very impressed with Brian Kendrick. He's doing some brilliant work at the minute.
Yeah, absolutely. So after that, we had the New Day.
New Day.
Versus Cesaro and Sheamus.
Cesaro,
yes.
Shame.
All right. But it's very good. I thought good match. It's good to see Xavier Woods wrestling again.
Yes.
It's a tough one to call who was going to win this one because they both had like, it's like, why would they have put Sheamus and Cesaro together if they're not going to have him win? But at the same time, they've been like bigging up like the record of New Day and how they're going to beat whoever they are. Who are they? They've got the record in a minute.
Demolition.
That's the one. So New Day ended up winning via shenanigans. Cesaro had Xavier Woods in the sharpshooter. Jesus Christ, my memory's terrible. And Sheamus, Biggie was going to help. Sheamus hit him with the trombone. Rest in pieces. Kofi with it. Kofi counted into the Trouble in Paradise, and the ref saw and disqualified him right as Xavier Woods was tapping out. So
Cesaro and Sheamus won.
Yes.
But New Day keep the titles.
Yes. Won by DQ. We both said New Day would win. So neither of us get a point for that.
After I was so adamant that Sheamus and Cesaro were gonna win and I changed my mind at the last minute last week.
Yeah. It was a good match, I liked it.
Interesting one as well, because I mean New Day are clearly going to beat that demolition record.
Yeah, I think so.
But I thought that they would then split Sheamus and Cesaro up, but apparently that's not the case and they're going to carry on. So we'll talk about Raw after we've done this, but certainly an interesting one.
Yeah, very interesting. So that brings us to our main events. Sasha Banks versus Charlotte, the first ever women's main event at the pay-per-view and first ever women's Hell in a Cell.
All that match. Making history. Making history every week.
Yes. So before the match even started, as the cage was being lowered, Charlotte attacked Sasha Banks, fought into the crowd, and then powerbombed Sasha onto the announce table, landing right in the goddamn neck again. Sasha, why do you hit your neck? You need it. Don't stop.
Someone took a photo in the crowd, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Like there was a still. and it's like Sasha's like core here, like her, like she's just absolutely ripped.
Yeah, absolutely. That's what that. But yeah. Yeah, they're going to call the match off. Sasha's getting wheeled off in a stretcher, and then the camera rope got caught in a neck brace. Oh, no, hold on, stop.
Shades of Mick Foley at King of the Ring 98 there, where he was obviously being wheeled off in the stretcher after taking that horrendous bump.
Yes.
And then he made that miracle recovery.
Yeah, crazy.
Apparently, before, like an hour before the show, the match itself was going to be a bit more extreme, and the winner was going to be the other way.
Oh, yeah, actually, yeah.
And then Vince McMahon changed his mind.
Because Manny didn't want to rush Charlotte versus Bayley.
They want to.
Yeah, yeah, because they want that merch sales and Bayley's wristbands and stuff, I guess.
Give us Sasha's own rematch.
Yeah, they'll probably do that more or something. It's a shame. Yeah. But, yeah, where was I? So, Sasha getting wheeled off, about to announce that Charlotte was the winner via forfeit. And then Sasha got up and like kicked the shit out of some poor EMT, ran back in the ring. Said, "No, I'm having this match." And then the match happened, and it was pretty good. It was okay. It was fine.
It was okay. It looked okay. Some bits were a bit awkward. There's a couple of botchy sort of bits in there.
Yeah, like tables not breaking.
Yeah, the table not breaking, that looked terrible because it didn't have a backup plan.
Yeah, it just kind of fell slowly backwards onto the table and just kind of like fell over.
Surely that wasn't the plan. It couldn't have been.
Yeah, maybe she was supposed to land on it and then Sasha was to jump on it, maybe.
Yeah, but in what world over. Was that ever going to work? I mean, it's not like they're light people. I mean, obviously, Sasha is tiny, but them tables are made out of polystyrene.
Pretty much, yeah.
Like, anyone's going to go, you'd go through it.
Yeah, I would, yeah. Anyone would. But yeah, weird. There's a cool spot where like Charlotte threw Sasha into the cage. Sasha grabbed on like Spider-Man, like jumped off and kneed him in the face.
Yeah, that was cool, yeah.
That was super cool. Other than that, it was fine.
Yeah, I didn't like the end. I felt like it was too abrupt.
Yeah. Charlotte threw Sasha into another table.
The table leant in the corner.
Yeah, but it not in a way then that it would break. So it just kind of landed on it and rolled off. And then
she Charlotte did natural hit. Selection.
Yeah. And this kind of won. And it was like, oh.
So I was like, okay. Was it supposed to end like that?
Yeah.
Or what? I don't know, but...
Bizarre.
Yeah, it was very strange.
Was it before the match started? They teased going up to the top of the cage and then just kind of stopped. It's like, well, you shouldn't really tease it if you're not going to do it. This makes people, gets people disappointed, gets the hopes up.
Yeah, and that's it. I mean, the match itself was fine and it's great to see the girls be in the main event and it's great to see them making history because we are in that sort of world now where that can be the norm. And the women's title can be just as prestigious as the Universal title. In fact, it's probably more prestigious than the Universal title.
Probably Universal
title. Really, and I'm more than happy to see the main event, you know, whenever.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think this was more of an occasion and not so much a groundbreaking wrestling match.
Yeah, pretty much.
But it was a fine match, all the same.
It was fine, yeah. Just take care of your neck, please, for God's sake. There's so many spots in this that got thrown up against the cage, landed on their neck. Dying to the outside, landing on the neck. Jesus Christ, be careful.
Yeah. Took a horrendous T-bone suplex or fall away slam or into the Hell in a Cell as well, where she landed directly on her head. And it's like, come on, Sasha.
Please be careful. We like you.
I'm all for the big spots, but, you know, safety is, you know, imperative, really.
Yeah. Take it easy, guys.
Yeah. But all in all, I thought the show was okay. I think we both had Sasha to win.
Yeah, we did. Both wrong. So that ends with me with 5. I think, me with 5 and you with 3. So we'll get another point. I mean, it takes me into the lead. Finally. Not to dragging behind for so long.
Yep. Well, so you're a point ahead now?
I am. I have 10 points. You have 9.
Ah, okay. Don't worry. I mean, that 1 point is absolutely coming to me because there is no way that the Shenmue HD collection is being announced year at all.
But at the same time, there's no way seeing them turn heel before the end of the year.
Have I had that, have I?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I'm sucking. I don't even know if he's even going to come back by the end of the year.
Probably not. Also, there's outstanding bet of The Last Guardian. I said it's going to get 80 above on Metacritic with the view scores. You said it's going to get below. It kind of, I think it's all coming down to that at the end of the day, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's all coming down to The Last Guardian. Oh, dear.
Come on, Last Guardian. Please suck. I don't suck. Just be
just kind of average and okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
All right, so that takes us to Raw. I've not got Raw notes, but I know you have. I've made comprehensive SmackDown notes. Cool. So that's good.
Yeah.
Together we've worked it out.
We have. Started off with Heyman saying stuff. Goldberg was there. Rusev came down, said some stuff. He got jackhammered. Heyman got speared. It was kind of weird.
It smelt of, we don't know what to do with Rusev now that he's out of that feud with Reigns.
Yeah.
Let's have Goldberg beat him up.
Yeah.
Sure. I'm rooting for Goldberg. I want to see him do well in his comeback match.
Yeah, sure.
I thought the worst when he sort of fell after doing the first couple of knees. I was like, no.
Oh, yeah. It's kind of tripped over backwards.
Like momentum took him backwards. I was like, oh. But then, you know, he made up for it. The jackhammer looked awesome. And his spear was great on Heyman. So,
poor Heyman.
It's cool to see Goldberg. Anytime, because we may as well make the most of him, because after the Survivor Series, I don't think we'll see him again.
Probably not.
Which is a shame.
Yeah.
It's nice to see him around at the minute.
Yeah, it's cool. It's a weird segment. It's fine.
It's fine. Rusev has a very strong beard.
He does. Good beard game.
His beard game is strong.
So strong. the first match of the night, it was Enzo versus Luke Gallows in a trick or street fight.
Yeah.
to kill me.
As soon as I saw it, like on the graphic with the pumpkins and stuff, I just thought, this is typical.
Yeah, way to ruin their win at Hell in a Cell.
Yeah.
It was super dumb. Lots of pumpkins, getting pumpkins smashed over them, and one point, Kyle Anderson got put through a table of trick or treat stuff. Gallows got a pumpkin butt in his head, awkwardly, which didn't quite fit because his head's too big. And Enzo wins,
So you have them win the tag team match at the pay per view,
yeah,
and then you have one of them lose to Enzo the night after.
He's just embarrassed with like pumpkins and stupidness. Why? What are you doing?
In 2016, right? These matches shouldn't be a thing.
Seriously.
I get that it's family entertainment, but most fans there don't want to see this kind of crap stuff.
Exactly. Yeah.
I don't. I saw it and I rolled my eyes and shook my head and I was like,
if you like this stuff, have it like Golden Truth versus Sonny Stars, isn't it? Not better to put the club
it's
in
like
there. Come
next
on.
Month, this month rather, when it's Thanksgiving in America, you know what's coming? The Thanksgiving food fight backstage. Of course that's going to happen. It happens every year.
Yep.
WWE will never change their ridiculous habits. They even showed highlights of last year's trick or street fight.
We'll just get that about.
Like Cesaro and somebody.
Oh, yeah. Boopy. After that, we had a match, rematch, TJ Perkins versus Brian Kendrick for the Cruiserweight title. TJ Perkins, didn't start the match, took a crazy bump to the outside, like a hurricanrana, and landed right in his neck on the apron. All these people land on their necks. Be careful.
it was a rough looking bump too,
It was a good match. TJP was on like full offense. He started the match like doing this, like, I can't remember what it's called, but like, dropped him on the shoulders and then kicks him in the head.
They call it the Lung Buster on the Cruiserweight Classic, but I'm not sure what they call it on this.
Yeah, weird. Call it a movie.
I know what you mean. Sorry, no. The Lung Buster's the one he does right before the leg lock.
Oh, yeah.
I know what you mean. So it's like a fireman's carry into an Enziguri type thing, isn't it?
Yeah,
I know what you meant,
Very cool. Almost got the three count straight away. Didn't, of course. So TJ Perkins tried to got back in the ring to break the count after doing that crazy bump. But Brian Kendrick was about to go back in, changed his mind, decided not to, and TJP wins via count out. So Kendrick's still champion. Smart. Smart Kendrick.
Smart Kendrick, and good booking as well.
Yes, very good.
I'm fully invested in this feud, even if the live crowd isn't. I'm very much into it.
Yeah, same.
I think it's going to be awesome. When this feud is over, I'd be interested to see who then goes for the Cruiserweight title.
Which one, I reckon?
Personally, I see Cedric.
Oh, yeah, that'd be cool.
Because he's well over. His stock's high in WWE. He's on everything.
Yeah,
Raw.
Seriously.
NXT. You know, he's on the CWC, obviously. But which makes me also think that Brian Kendrick's going to come out of this feud keeping the title.
Yeah, probably. There's less heels in the Cruiserweight division that people are excited about, I guess.
So yeah, because Drew Gulak isn't really over.
I like him.
But who else have we got?
The beardy, Neville-looking guy, I can't remember his name.
Oh, Tony Nese.
That's the one.
He's awesome.
He's great.
And who else was part of that three-man team?
The other one, Daivari.
Yeah, Arya Daivari.
That's the one.
Right, okay, yeah.
He was fine.
Sure.
Sure. Then we had the Battle Royal starring Braun Strowman.
Yep. So this was basically Braun's ticket to the Survivor Series team.
Pretty much.
And yeah, he won, last eliminating Sami Zayn.
Yep.
This was a nothing match.
Pretty much.
Just set up basically to have Braun win.
Yeah. Strowman ate him to finish it to start with. Fell out the ring, but through the middle ropes, so it didn't count. Came back after the match, eliminated pretty much everyone. And it looked like Sami was going to get out, eliminate Braun Strowman because he had him like on a headlock and pulling him out the ring with him. But no, Braun Strowman overpowered him and won.
I'm fine with it because, you know, we're fans of Braun here
yeah.
on this show. And this is what's going to take Braun to the next level. So oh, yeah. He's going to be Raw's big player, I think.
For sure.
And, you know, there's every chance that he could actually come out winning the whole match. But be interested to see how sort of everything pans out in the next couple of weeks. But, yeah, I think this is good for Braun.
Mm-hmm.
Good to see him sort of be pushed along the line a little bit.
Yes.
Instead of squashing jobbers every week.
Yeah. Some of the potential in Strowman. He can talk, he can move. It looks huge and dominating and, yeah, great. Love him.
It looks like he's willing to learn as well.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And he sounds like it's the way he comes across. Where, like, when you hear him on podcasts of, you know, like the Stone Cold podcast, he comes across very well.
Yeah. Very respectful.
Yeah. I've got a lot of time for that.
Yeah, me too. Good stuff. Then we had a segment between Charlotte and Bayley. To end up that feud. Basically, Charlotte said, you can't, you're not worthy enough to fight me. Here's someone you are worthy to fight with. And it was like, Nia Jax. She's back.
Yeah, I thought it would be Nia Jax. Yeah, when Charlotte was talking, I thought it was just Nia Jax.
Yeah. Good to see her back. Haven't seen her in a few weeks. And the match was pretty good, actually, I thought.
Yeah, it was fine. It's just very similar to the ones they had on NXT, I thought.
Yeah.
I thought they were going to go down the same route of Bayley winning with that sort of chin lock thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Glad they didn't.
Yeah, same. Nia was dominant through the match, but he did get some good offense in, and Nia ended up winning, which is good, I think. It's good for Nia.
Good for Nia. Bayley's selling injury as well, so to have her win would have been fairly ridiculous, I think.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is good for Nia. I mean, again, this is like Braun. She needs something to push her onto that next level because she's been squashing local talent, and you can't do it forever.
Pretty much, yeah.
And if you beat somebody good like Bayley, even though she is carrying a injury in quotes, I still think that's good. So yeah, good times.
Good stuff. We had a Cesaro versus the Shining Stars. Earlier in the night, Cesaro eliminated Sheamus from the Battle Royal. It's worth noting. But Cesaro won. It was a match that happened.
Yeah, sure.
More tension between Cesaro and Sheamus, but
I can't stress enough how much I think they've dropped the ball with the Shining Stars.
Yeah,
like, they're on that winning streak, and I genuinely thought they were onto something.
Yeah,
but then they just seem to have halted it real quick.
Yeah, it's fizzled out pretty quickly.
Very quickly.
But yeah, how's the match that happened?
Yeah, sure. I'm convinced that Sheamus and Cesaro, once the New Day have surpassed Demolition, will win the tag team titles.
Yeah, probably.
Now, because I genuinely thought they were gonna break them up after whatever the pay per view was. What was it?
Hell in a Cell.
Hell in a Cell. Yeah, literally a few days ago. I just can't remember.
What was it?
Yeah, I thought, you know, if they lost at Hell in a Cell, they'd break them up and then they'd have the official match to end the feud.
Yeah, yeah.
But apparently not. They're going to carry on with it. And because of this, I think they'll win the titles down the line.
Yeah, probably. I'm with you on that one.
Probably at the last. I think the New Day will surpass Demolition at some point in December.
Mm.
So when they do that, I think they'll either win at the pay-per-view in December, whatever it is, TLC.
Yeah, I think so.
Or they'll win it at the Royal Rumble.
Yeah. Agreed. Yeah. So after that, the main event of the night was Roman Reigns versus Chris Jericho for the US Championship.
Yeah, when they announced this, I was sort of thinking, this is good, but I thought they were going to enter them into a feud as opposed to having the match on the night. Because I'm all for Jericho getting a push towards the US title. Plus, as they mentioned, it's the only one he hasn't held.
True.
So I've got it now in my head that this is nailed on for him to win it at some point.
Yeah, maybe. Although it looks like they might be feuding Jericho with Seth Rollins, because obviously after the match at Hell in a Cell, he hit Seth with a crowd breaker and he was like the last one standing in the ring. It's like, interesting. But yeah, I wouldn't be against him going for the US title. That'd be cool. No. I almost thought he was going
to
win tonight.
He's going to stick around for a while as well, which he seems like he is going to. He's been around most of the year, if not all year.
I think so, yeah.
So he's on an awesome run and he's so over. He's managed to get a piece of paper over and a one-syllable word.
It. Yeah. Wow, he's a genius.
So yeah, he's just for somebody who can do that and be so funny every week,
yeah,
like, he deserves to be a Grand Slam champion and have all them belts.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I love Jericho. But yeah, it's a good match, I thought. At one point I thought he might actually win it. I thought, oh, cool. But no.
And do you think we're looking at Roman Reigns versus Kevin Owens going forward? Because Reigns said on Raw Talk, awful, that he wants to go for the Universal title.
Oh, really? Bringing the US title into the world title? Not sure.
Rollins did it, but again, this would set Reigns losing the US title up very nicely to Jericho.
True. It could happen, yeah.
These are all if, buts, and maybes at the minute. But,
yeah.
You know, obviously we're just speculating, but I would like to see Jericho win the US title and then Roman Reigns not win the Universal title.
Yeah.
But, there's so many different potential things that could happen.
Yeah, absolutely. That's a good match. Kevin Owens obviously helped. So obviously when the best back was done, I think he kicked him in the head a few times.
Quick side note in regards to the women. Mm-hmm. Do you think Sasha's going to return for them to have Sasha's rematch at TLC?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, probably.
That's a SmackDown pay-per-view, actually.
Good question. Let's have a look.
No, because we've got Roadblock as well. So one of them was going to be Raw, one of them was SmackDown.
TLC is SmackDown. Roadblock is Raw.
We've already had Roadblock this year.
We have. Second of the year. Weird. Mm. That's fine.
Fine.
Whatever.
Okay episode of Raw. Nothing special.
Oh, yeah. So obviously Reigns ended up winning that match. Just as Reigns was about to beat Jericho, Kevin Owens ran in and broke up the pin and disqualified.
Yep.
And then, and Seth came down to help. And then the crowd went crazy going, Shield, Shield, yay. It's like, so you boo Roman Reigns, but then you go nuts with the Shield, which Roman Reigns is part of. Roman the zone, no, boo. Roman with Seth, yay. What's happening?
Yeah. Fickle. Again, this is the fickle nature of wrestling fans.
Yeah. Bizarre.
Yeah. Raw needs to go back to 2 hours. We say it all the time. Everybody says it, but Raw needs to go back to 2 hours.
Completely agreed, yeah.
And
have Raw talk take be the third hour. That's fine.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm happy with that. That's like, you know, SmackDown has Talking Smack and that takes it the third hour. Fine.
Yeah.
But SmackDown gets it right, and obviously we're going to talk about SmackDown now, but I don't feel like SmackDown's a 2 hour show. I feel like it's actually less than that.
Yeah.
And technically it is with its adverts and all that sort of stuff. Yeah.
But,
it's just a better paced show.
Yeah. I agree.
So let's talk about SmackDown. James Ellsworth kicked off the show this week.
He did. Still around.
Yeah. Amazing that he's still around.
Yeah.
I hope they haven't signed him because joke's getting very old now.
It is a bit, yeah.
The t-shirt annoys me. The crap tattoos annoys me.
Yeah, it's a crap t-shirt as well. It's like, just his head. It's like, you could have done better with that. Come on. Make it look cool at least.
But that's the point.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah,
you want
right.
to make him look like a joke.
Yeah,
and it's I don't know. So he came out saying he wanted to apologize to Dean Ambrose. Dean Ambrose came out,
mm-hmm.
followed by AJ Styles. AJ was going on about how Ellsworth owes him his career and all this sort of stuff. Ended up in a brawl between Ambrose and Dean. Sorry, no, AJ and Ambrose.
That's the one. Ambrose himself.
Yeah, Ellsworth got thrown out of the ring. And Ambrose took a phenomenal forearm. Cut to the back. Daniel Bryan made a match between AJ Styles and Dean Ambrose.
Mm-hmm.
And if Ambrose was to win, he would be number one contender, but it was his very last chance.
Yes.
James Ellsworth was then told he could watch the match from backstage, but was not allowed at ringside.
Yeah. Naughty Ellsworth.
Fine.
Yeah, good.
good. Orton versus Kane, no DQ.
Yeah.
I wonder what's going to happen in this match.
Yeah, gee. Oh, Kane insisted it'd be no DQ. Why? You know what's going to happen, Kane. Come on. Yeah. You're smart. You've been around a long time.
Nobody can be buying this Orton with the Wyatt family.
Yes, yes, not.
You can see the turn coming a mile off.
Yeah.
Like, Orton is definitely going to turn on the Wyatts. There is no way he's going to grow a beard, start wearing smelly clothes, and join the Wyatts.
Yeah.
It's just not happening.
Not happening.
This match happened, and surprisingly, very quickly into the match as well, the White family interrupted. They beat down Kane. Randy Orton wins.
Yep. Fucking.
Whatever.
Yep.
Shocker. I don't like this. I think it's crap. I was all for the Randy Orton versus Wyatt, and all. I could just about tolerate the weird stuff that they were doing.
Yeah.
Like, even, magic. You know, Randy Orton's face turning weird in the mirror.
Oh, God, that was dumb.
And all that sort of stuff. But this, I'm just seeing it a mile off that Randy Orton's going to turn on Wyatt's, and it just seems too obvious.
Way too obvious. Unless unless that's a point that makes it seem obvious, but then it turns out, oh, there he was with Wyatt the whole time.
Yeah. And I'm fine with that.
Yeah, me too.
I'm absolutely fine with that, but it just isn't going to go that way.
Probably not.
Randy's had too much momentum as a face going for him.
Yeah.
For him to all of a sudden make this ridiculous U-turn and join the Wyatt. Oh, if you can't beat them, join them.
Yeah.
But who said you couldn't beat them?
Yeah, you only one match. Cheat
every week. You had Kane to help you. I don't know. I just think it's stupid and obvious that how it's going to end.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree. It's dumb.
Next up, we've got Becky Lynch and Nikki Bella versus Alexa Bliss and Carmella.
Mm-hmm.
Disappointing this week on SmackDown. No bum wiggle.
Yeah, no bum wiggle. Same.
But she's got darker hair.
Yeah, yeah, I didn't know that.
Which I like. Cool. I prefer it.
Yeah, cool. It's fine.
Yeah. No bum wiggle upsets me. Come on. WWE.
Hashtag bum wiggle.
Hashtag bum wiggle. Right. Hashtag save the bum wiggle.
Did you see Nikki and John's Halloween
thing? I did.
It burns my memory forever. Well, it's been seen, it cannot be unseen.
Yeah.
Now I have an image of Cena's doing Cena's bum wiggle.
Nikki Bella bum wiggle this week.
Yeah.
I watched, the fact they didn't show it on Total Bellas this week either.
Oh, you watched Total Bellas? Jeez.
I watch it with my
yeah, friends. I'm just kidding. It's fine.
But secretly, I love it. I love Total Divas as well. It starts this month. I'm excited.
Yeah, that's fine. It's cool.
And,
nothing wrong with that.
It's fine.
Yeah.
It's a good excuse to see Nikki and Brie in bikinis, like frolicking around by a pool as well.
True.
Goes home, watches.
I'm going to Google that when I go home.
No bum wiggle. That was basically the main takeaway from this match. It was a short match, and Alexa got the pinfall over Becky.
Yep, it's always a good decision. Showing her that she can beat Becky.
She won't, but.
It's just a shame because I think she'd be a good champion. But
yeah, it's too early to take the belt off Becky just yet.
Yeah, it is, yeah. Even if they don't like her accent for some stupid reason.
Although that said, I thought it was too early to take the belt off TJ Perkins. I was wrong.
Yeah,
we'll see. I don't think Alexa will beat Becky, but it gives the illusion that she could.
Yeah, exactly. Good booking. And then they had like a framework afterwards saying, we're going to beat SmackDown's team at Survivor Series.
They're going to beat Raw's team.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Going into that, Naomi's on Team SmackDown.
Good.
Natalya's team coach.
It's fine.
Why? I don't understand.
I guess they felt bad leaving her off. It's like, I've got to give her something to do. You can be the coach. Yeah.
Why not? The Spirit Squad.
Yeah.
Still around. Took on American Alpha. Winner went into the insane 20-man tag team match that they're having at Survivor Series.
Yeah.
It is a 20-man tag team because they showed that graphic afterwards with like a load of question marks.
Yeah.
But what is interesting, New Day is three men.
True.
Right? So
that's a good point.
Leaves an odd number.
I guess one of the New Day would have to sit out.
Yeah, but they've got all three of them there.
Have they? Oh.
Yeah. They've got all three of them on the graphic, and then the rest of the, like, I counted the spaces, and there's an extra one. So there's room for three more tag teams and one person.
I guess they could have another three-man tag.
Who
would that be?
Who?
Nobody! But yeah, I don't know. Who would that be?
Bring about the Freebirds.
Maybe. Question mark.
Yes, that's a weird one.
Yeah, very weird.
American Alpha won, surprisingly.
Shocking.
Yep. It was a very short match again. They're all short matches on SmackDown this week, actually.
Do a bit.
Miss TV. Maurice spoke in French. She sounds like, like on Eurovision where they give the points.
Oh, yeah.
She sounded like that. Like when she was introducing the show and she was talking French.
Right, okay.
Nilpois. For Great Britain.
Yeah, as always.
She looked hot as hell, though.
She always does,
red. I sent a photo of it to a friend of the show, Steve.
Nice.
And I think I can't remember what the text said. I'll read it out to you.
Four?
Yeah. We're not in the mid-90s now.
We're not? Oh, okay. What year is it? I guess not.
Shit the bed was the response.
Nice.
And then it was, have you seen the pics that Lana put on Insta with that dick-looking fruit emoji?
Yeah.
That's the kind of conversations that me and friend of the show, Steve, have.
Yeah.
Good segment with Daniel Bryan as the guest on Miz TV.
Yeah, very good.
I love this feud. I really love the feud. Daniel Bryan said that Miz wasn't going to be a part of Team SmackDown.
Good.
It was good. It wasn't even considered, and the crowd were chanting no along with it. It was very funny.
Yeah.
And there was a lot of heat. Daniel Bryan sort of flung a chair over and all this sort of stuff.
Yeah.
I refuse to believe there's going to be no payoff for this down the line.
There's got to be something, surely.
There has to be.
But do they really want Daniel Bryan resting again?
It depends what state he's in.
Yeah.
I mean, could he have one more?
Probably.
One last hurrah.
Okay, good.
And this Miz feud is built up enough where they would accept that Miz is a good enough opponent for him.
Yeah, I think so.
We'll see how it pans out, but I refuse to believe there's no payoff for this.
Yeah, it's got to be something, surely.
Yeah.
It's got to be something.
This took us to an IC title open challenge match.
Oh, yes.
I've written I Can't Stand Ziggler with a smiley face next to it on here.
still don't like him, huh?
No, I'm never going to. He's never going to win me over.
You don't like Ziggler's bum wiggle, he does?
No, can't stand it. Crap.
Yeah, I don't like how he has the title on backwards. Especially this week, he had like wearing a hoodie and he's covering it. It's like, can't even see it.
Yeah, it's pointless.
Yeah, it's done.
Rubbish.
I like when he's a wrestler. No.
Nope. Kurt Hawkins comes in and loses straight away. What's the point?
Yep, that's dumb. Stupid, dumb idiot.
I've written, is. For fuck's sake. Yeah. My notes.
It's stupid. Why bring him back? It was just going to have him lose like bloody Jinder Mahal and more. Why mother?
Pointless. Dolph Ziggler issues an open challenge to anybody on Raw for Survivor Series, as he was not going to give Miz his rematch.
Isn't it like contractually obliged to?
It is, but Miz wanted to do it on his terms.
Right, okay.
And then Miz went spare after the match. And that's the thing that's happening.
Fine.
Backstage interview with someone. The interviewer called James Ellsworth Ellis.
Right, okay.
She must have been talking to Dean Ambrose.
Yeah, I guess so.
James Ellis. Dean Ambrose did correct her, actually. It was Ambrose.
Oh, hi, sorry.
Backstage segment with Orton and the Wyatts.
Yep.
I've written I can't take it seriously.
Nope, I can't. I'm your snake. Snakes are like whatever. And
yeah, you're backstage in a hoodie and pants and... Snakes.
Snakes. So bad.
Snakes and...
Snakes are treacherous, that's the word.
We've got beards and you've not.
Yeah.
Yep, the headbangers are back.
Oh, good.
And they lost to the Usos in real quick time again.
Yep, shocking.
Yeah, that's it. So the Usos are on the Survivor Series team.
Yeah, good.
Because, you know, the headbangers were always going to win that.
Of course, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, I sit here and I say how much I love SmackDown. I think it's great. Yeah. And it is a really good show. But just some things are so questionable. But this is WWE in general. It isn't SmackDown as a show.
Yeah, SmackDown as a show is good. WWE is just weird.
Ambrose shows Ellsworth out the building.
Yep, kicks him out.
It was quite funny. He was like, it's cold outside and you're still in your tights.
Yeah, <sorry. laughs>
So that was quite funny. But AJ versus Ambrose, fun match.
Great match.
The Ellsworth circus continued.
Yeah.
And the security was sort of chasing him around the arena.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew it wasn't over when Ambrose showed him out of the building. There was just no way that it was going
to
be the end of it.
Yeah, something had to happen.
Yeah, of course.
Almost cost Dean a match.
He did. Then he came back. Yeah. AJ lobbed him into the announcers.
Yeah, that's
like,
funny.
Flung him in there like he was nothing.
Yeah.
Then he countered the phenomenal forearm into the Dirty Deeds, wins, and Dean Ambrose is number one contender again.
Hooray.
Hooray. It was a fine episode.
Yeah, it was good.
It was...
Some weirdness, but...
Yeah, some weirdness and some... Very, very short matches, but everything did its job in enhancing the SmackDown storylines that are going on.
Yeah, moving everything forwards in a meaningful way.
And as long as it does that, I'm fine with it.
Yeah, same here.
Wrestling is an interesting place at the minute. SmackDown's doing good. Raw needs to be 2 hours and, you know, work the same way that SmackDown does at the minute.
Yep, I agree.
Yeah. Pick a letter.
Q.
Q.
Yes. First, I think it's in my head. It's the most awkward letter I could have fixed, but there you go.
Right, yeah,
cheers.
So this week's episode of the Sonny and Finn Show is brought to you by the letter Q. And like last week, I'm going to find something obscure.
Sweet.
In the WWE Encyclopedia that begins with Q.
It's quickly becoming my favourite segment.
Yeah. Right.
Q is for...
have Qs in here.
Oh, I think we're wrestling called with Q.
Same.
Which
is going to make it even more obscure.
Yeah.
There isn't any.
Okay, I'll pick N for November.
N for November.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just looking at some of the baffling nonsense in this encyclopedia.
When I debut as a wrestler, I'm going to have my name start with a Q, just to be different.
N for November.
Yeah. New Age Outlaws, New Midnight Express.
Yeah, there's a lot of new in here new, for tag new, teams. New. Like they've had so many unoriginal ideas down the years that they've just put new in front of like old tag teams' names.
The New Rockers, The New Day.
Trying to find something. Oh, here we go.
Nation of Domination. Speaking of the nation, I like the new day's costumes. Yeah,
let's go for this. This is one of the more bizarre characters over the years.
Okay,
Nails.
Okay, yeah, I'm a Nails.
Okay, he was an interview with Big Boss Man, and apparently Boss Man locked him up. But I'll read it. So he was 6'5", weighed 302 pounds, from the Department of Corrections, of course. This is Nails with a Z on the end, not an S.
Of course, yeah.
Spelled incorrectly. After serving hard time in...
Go ahead and read it out loud.
After serving hard time in a Cobb County jail, Nails made a beeline for WWE, where he immediately attacked his former prison guard, the Big Boss.
Of course.
The ex-convict was so intent on exacting revenge from Bossman, in fact, that he didn't even bother to change out of his orange prison jumpsuit. Instead, he wore the state-issued garb throughout the entirety of his brief WWE career.
Yeah.
The hardened criminal pricked up his first major victory when he made short work of Virgil at SummerSlam 1992.
Okay.
3 months later, he finally had the opportunity to gain the upper hand from his former prison guard when the two superstars battled in a nightstick match at Survivor Series.
Nightstick match. God's sake.
Big Boss Man ultimately proved his dominance that night, and Nails disappeared from WWE shortly after.
Well. Good on Nails.
This week's episode of the Sonny and Finn Show was brought to you originally by the letter Q, and then because there was nobody by the name, by the letter Q, the letter N.
Hey.
I'm actually wearing a Sesame Street t-shirt
today. You are actually, yeah. Appropriate.
Good times. So yeah, that's a new segment, as well as... You just made the list!
Yeah.
Of games that have been released this month.
Yeah.
That's obviously only going to be a monthly one.
Of course.
Encyclopedia is a weekly one.
Yeah.
Good times.
Good times.
So this has been episode 37 of the Sonny and Finn Show.
Yeah.
We've had much to discuss.
Yeah, great.
It's been a pleasure.
Mm-hmm. As always.
We're going to play some sports bar VR.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you can beat me at pool.
So I can beat him at pool and then lose at darts.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's it. You got anything else you want to say?
Don't think so.
Okay. I'm Sonny.
I'm Finn.
This has been episode 37 of the Sonny and Finn Show. Go subscribe to us on YouTube, youtube.com/SonnyFinnPlay.
Yeah.
Subscribe to our podcast on iTunes, follow us on SoundCloud, and listen to us anywhere else that podcasts can be heard.
Yes.
But for now, we'll speak to you next week. Goodbye.
Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Bye. Divas.